Alright, go for it. Oh, wait, hold on.
I was like, I sucked in breath.
Yeah.
And I was just ready to just blow.
That was beautiful. Oh, you were ready to blow.
What is up, guys? And welcome to the Visual Wood Podcast, episode number 00.
We gotta do something about this. You need an intervention because you keep doing that.
That was the second time. I don't know why.
It's the third time.
No, it's the second time that I do that. Okay. And we're not gonna spend a minute talking about this again. We always do.
Do you think we could one day do a podcast? Okay. Mm-hmm. So, all right. Rewind the clock.
Yes, I think one day we can do a podcast.
No. Before we do the podcast, okay, me and you, we get in Skype. Before we start recording for people, we listen together. We like sync our audio like we do when we play games together, right? And we listen to the podcast we did 10 podcasts ago, right? And as we listen, we note down all the topics of conversation we go through. And then we record a new podcast and try to like perfectly replicate the old one, like but with a new like natural conversation and see who notices.
I think we could pull that off, to be honest. We should totally do that.
Because if it was like a podcast from last year, like who even remembers that? Like I sometimes use footage from my channel. Like if I'm doing Guild Wars stuff, okay, and I need to talk about something that happened in Guild Wars 1, I'll get old footage, 2008 footage I did, well, 2010 footage I did. People have seen that before, I've uploaded that before. Exact same thing, boom, in the video. It's cheeky, really, but people forget, you know, enough times pass. All I'm saying is we can just put the podcast on a loop now, they'll basically be reruns, but people won't notice.
So you just gotta take like, oh, you know what? I'm missing a video for today. Let me go back to my backlog. People haven't watched this. This has like 1,000 views. I did a lot of work.
Yeah,
this
dude,
one.
I just think about that a lot.
It real quick. Yeah, it'll work.
What are they? They're YouTube channels, all right? And what do TV channels do? Reruns are okay there. Why not on YouTube?
Because it's on demand and people can go back and watch it at any time.
Yeah, but they won't go back. You need to tell them to go back, you know, or just throw it in front of their faces. It's like the TV shows that get really high ratings just because they happen to be on after like the Super Bowl or whatever. You know, like nobody can be bothered to change the channel. So you just do that. I reckon a really legit feature YouTube should do is something like that, where like it features an old video you've done before for a day or something. That'd be badass.
It's so weird because like that was a problem because I when I was getting bigger in the Guild Wars 2 community, there was so much stuff that I did beforehand that was funny, but didn't really get a lot of views, but would get a lot of views now because, you know. Mm-hmm.
Because life is unfair and stupid.
Yeah. There's some Redditors like
Well, I mean, you do
some,
that anyway,
like,
right?
Very few. You know?
Like, you just reuse all your jokes, right? That's
Yeah. Dude, there's so... There's so many Guild Wars 2 videos that that took a while to do, and those will just never be watched ever again.
Because it was like news, and the news was years ago, and nobody cares about that news anymore. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah,
that's why you should never be creative. All right, you just need to write a script, follow it, done.
Absolutely, because creativity means more work, but no return investment. So.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That's it. So what you been playing, man? What's been going on?
What have I been playing?
Mm-hmm.
I was playing a game called Rodent's Revenge. Have you ever heard of this?
No.
I may have mentioned this on the podcast before. So I talked to Matt about this a while ago, but for the sake of everyone else, I have a file on my computer of every single game I can ever remember playing. Except, like, really big games and franchises that I'd never want to make videos on. But the theory is, one day, maybe I could do some massive project where we go through, like, all of these awesome, obscure, kind of nostalgic games for me. Like, and that is something that I'd really, really love to do. I showed you the list at one point, right? Or did I never end up sending it?
No, you never send it.
All right, well, it's an amazing list, and on the list is a game called Rodent's Revenge, which was, like, this ridiculously small, little game that came out maybe like 94 or something for the PC, where you play as like a mouse and you've got to get to all the cheese, which is hidden behind these little blocks, and there's cats everywhere. And if you break the blocks to get to the cheese, the cats can get released as well. And the object is to get at all of the cheese. And if you can't really think of it, right, this is 1994, so the kind of game it is, it's like a top-down grid-based game like Minesweeper, okay? Imagine like a Minesweeper window, except it's got little mouse and mice and cheese and cats and stuff on it.
That sounds familiar.
Yeah, maybe it does.
There's a lot of like, I don't know, if people don't really explore the internet and see that what it has to offer, like they just kind of like stay in their own like kind of bubble, you never really realize what's more, that the more things that are out there. Like there was this dude I knew back in high school that always sent me weird games that were like, it was online as well. Like there was this one. There was one where you were a mouse and you had to work together with the other mouse to get the cheese, and there are obstacles. And
are you talking about Transfer Mice?
That's what it is.
Yeah, Transfer Mice, dude. That is the greatest game ever.
Yeah.
That is the greatest. And you could have the Shaman, right?
Yeah.
And so for people that don't know, the Shaman is this one. So it's like a room that you get tons of people in, like 20 people, and they're all mice, right? But one out of those 20 people gets randomly chosen to be the Shaman. And the Shaman can summon objects in and manipulate the environment and stuff to help the other mice get across the obstacle course of the cheese.
Or kill them,
yeah. So you could be like a Shaman that creates this bridge that's like teetering off of this ridiculous seesaw angle, and then just as the zerg of mice try and jump over it to get to the cheese, you knock it off and they all plummet to their death. What a game! There was some serious skill cap in that game too. Did you used to do like the little like the wall jumps and stuff?
Yes. I learned how to do that and survived a couple times. I'm like, oh yes, finally. Because some shamans were really evil, man. Others like draw stuff right in front of you. I'm like, nah, come on.
Just box you in, yeah. It's really weird. Matt already knows this, but my PC, I was doing a lot of stuff to try and improve it over the week. And at one point, it was basically completely dead when I was trying to overclock it. I'd like really messed up, basically, and I could not boot through the... it wouldn't even get to like the BIOS screen. I had to eventually flush the CMOS, actually open it up and pull this little battery off of the motherboard. But at that time, I turned on my old PC, which is a really old PC, and on the desktop for that PC was Transfer Mice, the old client that I had installed. And I haven't thought of that game for so long, but I saw that, and then you mentioned it here today as well. Really weird.
What I want to say is, like, I used to be in that bubble where I just kind of went to my websites, you know, my bookmarked websites. I didn't know that this whole other world existed. And then there's just so much out there, like, so many little games that I've played. I was like, this is so obscure. Like, no one knows about this. Like, I guess nowadays there's like Reddit and all those boards and all those.
Yeah, all you need is Reddit
spread.
Now.
Yeah, you can kind of spread some of this stuff out. Because back then, you will stumble onto something crazy from a website and you're like, wow, this is really cool. But not many people are playing, or they have like that set group that, you know, logs in after school. You know,
it's
crazy. I kind of enjoyed that type of community. I remember being in this modding Call of Duty community, like way back on PC, and crazy stuff you should do with Call of Duty. Back then, when Call of Duty was considered something better than it is now. Mm-hmm. You know, no one cared about, oh, you're playing Call of Duty, you're just a little kid, but like no one thought about that back then, because Call of Duty was like a really cool PC game. That you could just mod the heck out of, and it was really fun.
Now, you're going to call me a stalker here, all right? But yeah. I really think you should do this. We talked about this before. What do you think about getting in contact with those old guys? Do you remember any of their names?
No, I remember one dude because I met him in high school, but that's pretty much it.
Damn.
Yeah, like, I don't remember the website I used to.
I really want to set us up in this situation where you end up doing, like, an awkward video where you hunt down a guy, like you're vlogging about it, you hunt down a guy you used to play like Transfer Mice with or something.
Knock on the door with a camera.
Yeah, and he's like, who are you? And you're like, yeah, it's your buddy Matt. And it's like deliciously awkward. I love that so much.
Yeah, and then he'll be like, Matt? I don't know any Matt. Oh, my username was like buttclenching07.
Yeah.
He's like, oh! Yeah, you were a douche, dude. Like, you know, like, hey, no, was it?
No, he'd invite you in, and then you'd play together, and that would be like the happy ending. Be like one of those stupid daytime TV shows. It would be amazing.
And
you
then
could call it Gaming Connections.
And then you play with them, and then you realize that he grew in the wrong direction.
What does that mean?
You kind of grew apart, you know? It's just, it's not meant to be. It's a shit.
The relationship isn't there anymore when you don't have Transformers to play.
Right, right. Right, we go out to eat, and all we can think about is mice. And you're like, we have nothing else in common to talk about, nothing.
It's kind of weird. I just with a friend for a laugh the other day, played RuneScape again. Just logged onto a free server with my old tune from like 2007 or whatever it was.
I do that
and
once in a while.
The game is obviously crazy different, but it was really sad. He was like, add me to your friends list. All right, okay, we did it. We started killing, like, giants in, like, this dungeon under Varrok, and it was, like, all nostalgic and stuff. But I logged in, and I looked at my old friends list, and it was just all these old names, all these people, and, like, you vaguely recognize the usernames of these guys. You're like, I sort of remember you. God damn, I sort of remember you. All these names on this long, long, long list, and they were just all offline.
All of
so
them.
So sad.
Every single one of them are offline.
Yeah, there's
it's
no
so
way anyone
weird.
Would still be on.
I logged on into RuneScape and MapleStory, and just like everyone's offline. Everyone's
it's
offline.
It's so weird with RuneScape, though, because it's still such an active game. Anywhere I was walking, there were tons of people talking about stuff, people swearing at each other, people begging for gold, people doing all kinds of things. It's still such a popular game, and yet there's this insanely huge graveyard of dead accounts and people who don't play anymore. Like
that's because people kind of move on. That's yeah. What happens constantly. I mean, you can't really blame, like, for instance, Arenanet for catering to new players because they keep bringing in new players. And it replaces the people who don't want to play anymore.
And people who get lives and stuff, yeah.
Right, right, so exactly. Say, people who have a baby. Like, no, I ain't even thinking about no Guild Wars 2 when I'm having the baby.
You should, because then you can make a video. I've got all these, like, terrible but awesome ideas, right? Then you can make a video of your baby trying to play Guild Wars 2. And at first it can be like a joke, like a mock on, you know, people who are like, here's my six-year-old playing the game. And at first it can be like you're making fun of them. But then in 6 years, you can do it legit. And people will be like, oh, your baby is so cute. I mean, hell, you don't actually need your own baby for that. You could just go to, like, the nursery and take one.
Yeah, that's totally acceptable, guys.
You put it back.
We do not. Yeah, yeah. Anyways, so I've been playing other than...
Sorry, yeah, I never asked. What have you been playing, Matt?
Other than Echoes, Guild Wars 2. Other than Guild Wars 2... We were actually playing together.
What is that? That was crazy. Yeah, I know. We went in Skype.
And you invited me. I was like, hold up, what? I always... Like,
and you never made a big deal of it.
Ever since we got inside of the beta, I've always asked, do you want to play together? Do you want to play together? Because it's so boring when you're by yourself in Guild Wars 2.
Well, look, it's out of necessity as well. We can't talk about the next patch, I guess, right?
Yeah, well, at least... I think we can at least say this. The music is tight. I kept saying the music is so good. I get tired of hearing the same songs over and over again. And man, they have a few different tunes, not just one tune, like a few different tunes throughout the map. And it's area.
There's a bit later on as well, okay? And where they remix an old tune. And it makes you, like, cry with happiness because of where you are and what's going on. That's pretty vague. I was going to tell you, though, the main reason I played with you and invited you, it's just out of necessity. It's because there's so much group content, right? Like, I can't do it alone. So, I mean...
Wow. So I'm just being used. Okay.
Yeah, well, look, if I'm honest
guys,
about it...
See?
It's okay.
See? Here is winning potatoes. Here it is. Suck
well,
it
I'm
in, guys.
I'm just an independent person.
Suck
right?
it in. You know what he's gonna go do, right? It's not everyone. It's just me.
What do you mean it is everyone?
He's gonna get Halo.
It is everyone.
And he's gonna play by himself.
He's gonna play with his brother.
He's gonna play with his brother.
Right.
You know why? He just hates me. That's it. That's all it's been.
Dude, it's because I don't own an Xbox One.
Everyone who meets Wooden Potatoes, it's fine, right? Remember you, Boots, World of Enders? He's totally fine with Wooden Potatoes. Best friends, dogs, homies. Y'all play together all the time. Me and Wooden Potatoes? Nah. You know what? Matt? I think, you know, he's just too dark for my taste.
Look, wow, was that a racist remark?
No, it was
not.
Dude,
I was going to say, I watched on your newest review, okay, I find the black jokes hilarious, but I do find it kind of ridiculous that you are literally, I'm going to join the club now, I'm going to join everyone else who says this, you are a white guy that is allowed to make black people jokes, and it's outrageous. All right? It is so unfair, it's ridiculous.
Oh my god!
What do you say in defense of
that? I need that quote on my tombstone. A white guy who was allowed to make black jokes.
That's quite a good tombstone, actually.
Here lies Matthew Dawkins.
Boom.
There it is. There it is. That's my real name. I'm pretty sure I love you.
I don't know, actually. You don't really say that much. You don't really say your real name. I think a lot of people would spell your name wrong as well, your first name.
Yeah, they often do. I was like looking at this list of stuff because I'm in charge of the AV team, and I was like, oh, Matthew, spelled with a W.
Wait, you're in charge of the what?
Audio, editing, and stuff like that.
Okay.
At the church, I always told you. Yeah, yeah. And I was looking at my name, and I was like, why is there two T's and a W here?
Well, it's because that's the normal way of spelling it, not the pretentious French way of
excuse me. Excuse me. My mother had taste.
It is more tasteful. It is more tasteful.
It looks good, too.
Do you prefer it? I would probably prefer it if I had your spelling.
I didn't like the W. I don't know. I could have been a different person if she named me with a W, dude. Can you imagine?
Whoa. Matthew, I could be talking to Matt. I may not even be talking to you right now.
Mm-hmm.
What if that version of Matt, I don't know, never left uni, was so angry with his mother for using this spelling that when she needed him while he was at uni, chose to leave her to the wolves and stayed.
And she was devoured.
And yeah, she was devoured. And along it was her tombstone sister. You were standing over.
No, my little sister, she survived. And then she became very powerful and then came back and killed me.
And okay, well, like a superhero or a supervillain?
No. Supervillain. Definitely super
Dude, let's talk about superheroes. Do you want to talk about superheroes?
We could do superheroes, yeah.
Did you see the Marvel conference thing where they announced, like, literally the next 20 years or something ridiculous of Marvel movies?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I heard the announcement, but I didn't watch it.
There are so many, like the Ant-Man thing. Did you know much about Ant-Man before it was revealed he was going to be coming out in these movies?
Yeah.
You knew about Ant-Man?
I've read a couple comic books way back, yeah.
See, I never knew anything about Ant-Man, and I, like many other people, I'm like, what? They're going to do a movie about Ant-Man? This is going to crash and burn. This is going to be terrible, right? Like, it seemed really ridiculous that they'd even go for it. And now everyone's like, oh, you know, they did Guardians of the Galaxy really well, so we'll give it a shot. But you look at their next lineup. It's crazy. There's so many, like, nobody superheroes that people that are ignorant or don't really read comics, like me, like your normal person, you just have no idea. Do you know who the Inhumans are?
Not really, no.
They're like mutants, but from another planet, and they're like their own like superhero team. They're getting a movie. I've never heard of them. I'll be honest. I don't even really know who Black Panther is.
He's black.
Okay, but do you know anything about Black Panther?
He did make an appearance in a show I was watching, way back. I used to be heavily into stuff. I had some of his comics, but like, I don't like to start from.
The middle? Yeah, and that's comic books all over, right? Like, where do you start?
And I was like, oh, man, now I have to go find issue one. It's just like, oh, too much work. But I didn't really read much about the Black Panther, but that should be interesting.
He's getting one. He's getting a movie. Doctor Strangelove. Do you know who that is?
Benedict Cumberbatch, is he going to play Doctor Strange?
Apparently, that's like the big rumor. Apparently, yeah, he's going to be that guy.
I
have no idea
guy.
Who that is.
I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the weird face. I don't know. It's weird.
Because he
it's
has
weird,
got a weird face. Everyone
handsome,
think...
and it's kind of
it, though?
Not as well.
It's not handsome, is it? It's not.
It's weird. It's weird. It's I don't know. It's one all right, of those...
Matt, listen to yourself, okay? If I said, if I met you, if you meet me, okay, mm-hmm. and then your response is, he's got a weird face, right? Right? That's not a compliment. That doesn't go hand in hand with handsome. I'm sorry, he's not attractive. Dude, everyone's like, oh, he's kind of
is, dude. Kind
of
is.
It's just because of his accent and that he's tall and he tends to wear suits and he tends to be intellectual.
No, there's two kinds of British people. There's the ones that annoy the heck out of me who talk like they know everything, and then there's the people who know how to act. Sometimes both of them are put together.
Wow. Jesus. I mean, it's not just me offended here right now. It's every British person listening that's offended right now. So
which
I would
is
be
pretty much half of my audience. I'm sorry, guys. You know, it's a joke. You know, at the expense of the audience. You know what I'm saying?
I think you should give a shout out to that one guy in that one country that like watches you. Do you know what I mean? Like, when you look at your analytics,
oh, yeah.
you find out there's, like, one guy in...
I don't know their names, though. But I get, like one person in Central America. Is it Central America or it's a town in Central America that's watching me? Like, this
well,
is
it probably,
little
it's probably a country that...
Not town. Yeah, I mean country. Sorry, I don't know why I said town. I have no
shout
idea.
Out to the guy in this one town. Oh, my God, that's right. It's like when a rock star comes to your town and they're like... We love you, San Diego, or whatever, right? Like, your tiny little town.
Yeah.
And you're like, ah! Everybody goes crazy over it, even though they're just clearly feeding you a line. I love that.
That's only rock stars, where they come and they take your groupies.
Okay.
That's pretty much what they... When they say, I love you, San Diego, they really love the groupies, is what they're saying.
Get some of that groupie on the side. Do you want to do an iTunes review?
Yes.
All right.
We didn't quite talk about any of the games that we mentioned, did we? We were terrible.
Yeah, hold on. What game were you playing? I forget already. What were you playing?
All right. Well, for Halloween, I just came from a long night of playing Civ 5 Beyond Earth with Super Bunny Hop.
Right, okay.
We went over, we got some takeout, and then we came home, did some Civ 5. So basically, he hooked up two mice
to his
PC. I was about to say mouses, but I was like, no, that doesn't sound right. Two mice to his PC, and what happens when you hook up two mice is
they both share the same cursor, right?
Yeah, they share the same cursor. So we would take turns against the AI, and you know, at first, you know, George is weird, so I was like, oh. Is he going to attack me or we're going to be cooperative? But we end up being cooperative, sort of. And then, oh my gosh, he starts getting attacked by some random guy. Because we were about to attack this like douchebag. There's this, she's black like I'm black. Like she's light skinned black. And she's just so like, she comes
Can I
out
ask
like,
why that's
oh,
relevant?
I demand you for you to open your borders. It's like, damn, like, it's like a cop coming up to you, like, spread your cheeks. It's like, geez.
Wait. Are you talking about a person or, like, a video
game?
It's
an
like,
AI.
An
so
AI.
The AI,
okay.
The AI right. would ask you for, like, they'll trade, but they'll, like, demand it sometimes, too. Because she was getting powerful very quickly. She started working with another dude, and they started trading resources constantly. And she just kept growing in power. And she wasn't peaceful, but the other guy was the top guy who had like all the resources and was super friendly, was like a top guy, and he didn't want to go to war for anyone, nothing. Like he was just a friendly guy, but I bet when he reached maximum awesomeness, he's gonna kill everybody. But he was just being so nice to us that we didn't care. We wanted to kill the woman who kept trying to demand stuff and like taking my land. She built a damn city on my road, so I couldn't use the road anymore.
What? Right, is so, that all right, really?
All right, so you it's a little bit different. It's like a turn-based strategy game. So you will start with like your...
You do like a round, right?
Like a base, and it will develop into a city, and you keep like building stuff around that city as you spread out. There's
world,
a lot
right?
of resources. It's a little bit overwhelming at first. But then you start getting used to it like really quickly. It took me a couple of hours, and he didn't know he's never played it. He's thinking about reviewing it, So I
okay.
We just jumped in there, and we seemed to figure it out. And I was a little bit worried because I didn't, you know, those types of games.
Have you ever really played much Civ before?
No, I have not.
Yeah,
no, have
like not. This. My experience of Civ as well was I've barely played it. I know it's this ridiculously addictive game, like really addictive. Like you see, like these conversations people have. They're like, "What is that one game you played for like 48 hours straight and you just couldn't put it down?" And a lot of people's answer to that will be Civ. So like, I know it's this huge thing. But it's intimidating, right? It's like, and I had this experience when I was younger where I was at a friend's house and we went to a neighbor's who was playing like Civ 2. This was years ago. And this guy was hooked on Civ 2. He was like, oh, this is the greatest game ever. And I was bored out of my mind. Like for so long, we were just sat there watching this guy play. It was so boring and complicated and lame. And I never really got into it after that. And this was your first experience, was it?
No, I played a little bit of Civilization way back.
Like but back didn't then, enjoy it?
Nah, I was more of an Age of Empire, nations type of guy.
Okay.
Was it all nations, end Asians? Nations?
End of Nations.
End of Nations, that's it. Mm-hmm. I really like End of Nations. Those were really, really fun. Like, just you type of crap you can pull off in that game. Building up from, like, Stone Ages. It was real time instead of strategy.
Wait. You're not talking about Age of Empires, are you?
Well, they're both kind of the same.
Yeah, right.
They're both.
I've never played much Age of Empires, but I played a lot of Master of Olympus and Stronghold, which were two old PC games, sort of in the same ish genre.
Yeah.
But yeah, like City Builders, right?
It's funny how these games kind of, yeah, City Builders. It's funny how these games kind of like float in the background now. Like no one makes them anymore because people don't really have enough time to kind of sit down and play so much. Civ is pretty much the biggest one that people talk about. But like, you know, long story short, it was fun to learn the game. And you know, when you have company and you're just talking and learning and, oh, what should we do? And then there's like random quests that would appear that you can, I mean, it had good text, but after a while, you kind of realize, oh, there's two options. Pick the one that benefits you more because it shows you what you get for picking that option, even though, like, you can't think about morals when you're making decisions.
Oh, wow.
You got to think about stuff.
Does that mean you were invading people and you were being just as bad as this person that you seem to hate?
Invading people, that's tough. That's a war. You're declaring war. And what would happen, just to finish up, is we built a road to each other. And when you build a road, your units move faster on that road. So he was getting all his units, and he was going full on, I don't know, barbarian build. You know, because there's lots of stuff you can research and upgrade. And I was going into science, so I was, like, basically crazy efficient after a while. Like at first I was getting less energy and less energy, and all of a sudden my energy just like quadrupled. Not even more than that. I was starting to getting like I don't know, I went from -2 to like 70 energy every turn, and I was like, wow, this is amazing. I don't know if it's every turn, I don't know if, but it's a lot. Plus 70.
Right.
And it would say, like, plus how much you're gaining every single turn, I think.
Yeah, like rounds,
and we're about
right?
to attack. All of a sudden, the Indian girl comes up. Like, all the girls were douchebags. All the guys were nice. All the girls were douchebags. We had the Brazilian guy that was kind of like, you know, sure, I'll negotiate with you to open up my borders. And then the other guy was just, like, extremely friendly. All the rest of them were women who wanted to take everything.
You know, I think that's a really interesting segue into a near and dear topic to my heart, which is Gamergate and how games treat
women. No! And then Sunset Overdrive, of course, I played that. But, of course, there is a review on my channel, just in case you...
Oh, nice plug.
Plug! Okay, iTunes review.
So if I want to learn about Sunset Overdrive, I should go to youtube.com/mattvisual, and look at the playlist, Visual Reviews. It's not a funny one. It's a nice, well thought of one. I'm doing it because it's the most recent. There was one about a guy who liked to fap while listening to the podcast that I thought was pretty interesting. But instead, we'll go with Jet Powers, who says, "This podcast is great. I love listening to them while playing either Guild Wars 2 or something else. Keep it up, guys."
What was his name?
Jet Powers.
Jet Powers. Oh, okay. He's been listening for a while.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you very much, Jet Powers. You're now immortalized on this podcast. In 1,000 years, when all that's left are hard drives that, you know, from internet servers, someone's going to listen to this. And they're going to be like, wow, these were interesting fellows. They played video games? Like, they don't even know what video games are because the apocalypse has happened, right? But now they're thinking about you, Jet Powers. Jet Powers. That's like an action hero name as well.
Yeah, Jet Powers.
Oh, my God.
Friday. Wow. I had something to say. Okay. And right. I totally blanked.
Was it a segue perhaps into the audio adventure, which I never did?
Are you serious?
I can do it for you live. I can do it for you live if you like.
Are you serious?
No, yeah, I'm serious. I'm serious. I
all those times you paused during when we were supposed to be recording?
Yeah, I know, but I can do it for you live. Are you interested in a live audio adventure?
Sure. It will have to do.
All right, hold on 1 second.
As he, you know, looks around for some type of object, obscure object.
What was just happening? This was my plan, okay? All right? Uh-huh. Okay. All right, here we go. So this is the audio adventure. It's very similar to the previous audio adventure. I'll say that much, okay?
Great. Yeah. Oh.
Ready? I'm going to give you 10 seconds of me doing this, and then you're going to have to figure it out, all right?
All right.
There you go. That's it. And the bang at the end is a part of it.
Okay. So, all right. That sounds... The bang at the end sounds like it's wood. But I was going to say, like, just like a plastic thing with beads in it. Because that's sure enough what it sounds like.
That's guess one over. No.
So we're strict with yours, huh? Okay, so is it a game?
No.
Like, I would say you're on the right game at all. No edgy game.
No. You're on the right kind of thoughts that it is for entertainment, but it's not a game.
Okay.
Okay.
Is it those? No, that's too many bead sounds. I was gonna say if it was like that magnet ball thing
where magnet ball thing.
Yeah, you never seen those magnet ball things where there's like four balls, and then the two balls
what kind of
at
toy
the end will
about
slam
right
the two balls in the middle, and it will hit the third ball.
Oh, you're talking about like not an abacus, but you know one of those things that demonstrates the transfer of energy.
Mm-hmm.
So you plink one and it comes up the other side and there's five hanging and you can do various combinations. You can swing two and see one. Yeah.
I
don't
watch those balls forever, man.
I do have one of those actually. When I was younger, there was this woman's house we went to, right? And I don't remember very much about her at all, right? But she had all over her living room, right?
Balls.
All these like, you know, it's sort of like the ball thing we're talking about, right? Uh-huh. But they were like all these statues, like metal statues that were all on pendulums. So it was like. One would be like a dolphin, and you would just flick it ever so slightly, and it would start moving. And it was designed in such a perfect balance kind of way that once it started moving, it would keep moving for hours and hours and hours. And it wasn't battery powered or anything. It was just very slowly stopping. But because of the way that they were designed, they would just keep going. She had them all over her house. So whenever I was there, I was a kid, I used to like make them all move. And it's a really creepy memory to me now. I'm like, who has all that stuff in their house? Which is the whole living room would just be moving with all these dolphins and clowns and stuff spinning around.
Oh, sounds like a fun house.
Yeah, it was scary. Sort of where you get slashed up in a horror movie.
Slashed up. Wow, such a vivid image. Slashed up. Mm-hmm. Would you like some pie, Mr. Wooden Potatoes? Instead of like cutting the pie, she like grabs your hand and puts it into the pie.
Oh, what are you doing?
Slicing.
What are you doing? No. Whoa.
This is Halloween. I had the...
Oh, this is the Halloween pods.
Woo! Halloween! Even though Halloween is over, but you can still eat your candy while listening to the pod.
Yeah, do you want to do a scary
MMO
story?
Or whatever you do. Or cleaning. Are you cleaning right now? You better clean right.
Do you want me to read you a short, scary story?
Move the refrigerator. Move the refrigerator. Get behind the refrigerator. Get inside those crevices now. You can't just be lazy while you're cleaning. That's right, you. I'm talking to you. Don't stop cleaning. I didn't tell you to stop. I can't remember.
That is scary. Someone forcing you to clean. Whoosh, cracking the whip. Seriously, I've got a really short horror story. Do you want to hear it?
Yeah.
All right, for the Halloween theme. And then you're back to the audio adventure. All right, here we go. I woke up in the middle of the night because of hunger. Mum and I were not eating yet, not even lunch nor dinner. Mum didn't earn anything today, that's why we don't have money to buy any food. I hate the fact that Dad left us. He left us with nothing but misery and
suffering.
Is he black? Dude, look, see, this is exactly what I'm talking about. That's inappropriate, right? Okay. We didn't open with a disclaimer saying Mad Visual is black, so he's allowed to make those comments. You know, some people might not know that. Get reported. I went down to the kitchen to drink some water until slices of fried meat caught my attention. My mouth watered as the aroma of it entered my senses. I ate some of it. It was very tender and tasty. I was about to eat the last two slices until I noticed a note on the table that says, "Honey, eat this dinner. I cooked it just for you. Don't mind me. I'm not hungry." I smiled. Mum really loves me. I put the two left slices on a plate and went up to Mum's room to give her some. I'm sensing that she's not eating yet. When I opened the door to her room, I was surprised. Mum's already dead, and her left hand was missing. Ring, 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 ring.
Wow, that's creepy.
Yeah, it's good, right?
So,
yeah.
The family was definitely not black. because black mamas wouldn't do that. I cut my hair for you, child.
Oh, dude, have you been... You relinked me that woman that did the cooking video, right? Where she was talking about,
all
the fried stuff. Oh,
what's
my God.
Again?
I can't remember, but she's the greatest person in the world.
Auntie
Nora or something?
Yeah, something.
Aunt Fee, sweet treats.
Aunt Fee.
I call them... Well, they got to have a name, right? They got to have a name. I don't know. They're just something for the kids.
Something for the kids.
Yeah, but what
something
are they...
Sweet for the kids.
Yeah, what are they going to do? Come over and say, "I want something sweet for the kids." All right, you're right. How about Aunt Fee's sweet treat? Oh, what a video.
Yeah, it's like, they look like jail food. Man, shut up.
yeah. Oh, I love it.
Oh, my gosh. That is that is good.
All right, we're getting way off topic here, though.
Yeah, it's because I feel like there's a lot of people who don't normally see that, you know? I think, I don't know, like, people who didn't grow, not necessarily, like, oh, white people, but, like, everyone who hasn't grown up in that atmosphere would look at that and think it's funny, you know, because they just never exposed to, like, the ghetto-ness. But, I grew up with stuff like that, and we would laugh at that. It's still funny. It's just that I'm kind of used to, like, people talking that way. Back then, when I used to live in that type of neighborhood, and it's even worse in Georgia. Like, holy crap, the ghetto-ness is like times 10 here. It's ridiculous.
And you can look back fondly.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
All right. Okay. Well, no. Back to the
Halloween
audio adventure.
Story, dude. You're getting everything from this podcast. What?
Yeah.
We got the
so
iTunes review. We doing things. So, we know Movie Club. We still have yet to pick one, but we're going to pick one before this.
Well, what are you doing? Are you just running away with it here? Huh? What about the audio adventure? You're giving up?
Oh, then why do... Hold on. What
this
just
is what
happened?
I've been trying
why
to tell
we,
you
Why did we
for
go
ages?
To a story?
I don't know, because I really wanted to read a story, so we just ended up doing it.
Oh, okay. I don't know. Man, we are... If you just go back and listen to the podcast, like, we just constantly just talk. For 3 hours, okay?
And oh, yeah, that's a good point.
I don't know how we do it, but we just do. All right, anyways, I'm not gonna get off track.
Do you want a hint about the audio adventure?
Yes, I do.
Okay, it's got my hand on it. What? No, that's a legit hint.
Oh, no, it's... Oh, excuse me?
It's got my hand on it.
What do you mean it has your hand on it? What do you mean? You have your hand on it right now, or is that a clue in some
it's
weird
on
way?
The table. Right. Okay. And it's got my hand on it.
Okay. So that means you use it, is what you're saying?
No, I'm not touching it. But it's got my hand on it.
Wow, this is starting to sound really weird. I'm not going to lie.
There's a reason I just read you a story about a woman who cut off her hand. Ah, I cut off my hand!
That makes bead sounds like that? It sounds
They're not beads,
like
bro. Beads. They're not beads.
I know, but it sounds like beads. It's that sound. Let me hear it one more time.
All right, here we go. Okay. I'll give you another hint. Okay, here we go. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Now, it doesn't have my hand on it.
Oh, it's not beads. It's a glove thing with the Velcro.
What?
It's no. Velcro, isn't it?
No, it's not Velcro.
It's not Velcro? All right, fine. I give up. No. Go ahead.
All right. I actually don't... Oh, my God. I don't know how to describe it. It's one of those things, okay, where... It's loads of, think about like grass almost, right? Lots of long, little metallic like rods, loads of them all next to each other. And so if you hold your hand on it and then slide them over your hand like this, okay, now loads of them have fallen down except the ones where my fingers are. So now there's like an imprint of my hand there. And then I can take my hand out and it's made a print of my hand and I can put it down on the desk and I got like a hand there. Or you can do it on your face or your ear or whatever, and it makes all these weird pretty patterns. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Obscure.
It's not obscure. It's a really common toy. Trust me. If you don't know what it is, everyone will know in the podcast. I don't know what it's called, though. Hand imprint metal toy. This is the future right here. This is Google. The power of Google. Yeah, it came up. Look, hand imprint metal toy. This is exactly what it is. When you see this, you'll recognize it. They describe it as needles, all right?
Link me.
Check this link out. You know what that is?
Yeah. Oh, I've seen this before.
Yeah, you do. Damn right you do. There you go. See?
Wow. See? Wow.
That's what it is.
That I is think that was so a pretty obscure. Good one, right? It's like, oh my gosh.
But it makes a distinct noise. I bet people did get it. Leave a comment if you got it early.
Nope.
Leave a comment. A comment even if you didn't get it early, just to prove me right and make Matt feel bad.
Great. Great. We should have a live podcast and so we could know when people are lying. Like, nope, you didn't get it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But then you could have cheated. You could have seen what they were saying because they all would have got it. And then you can be like, oh, I just guessed it. I wasn't looking at Twitch chat. Oh, it's like when Hearthstone people, like streamers, look at that are bad at the game and they look at Twitch chat to know what to do.
Hey. None of that. Don't be dissing Twitch streamers. Anyways, so movies and TV shows.
Okay.
You want to start? Have you been watching much?
Well, I watched a movie based on a recommendation of a friend. You know how a few weeks ago I said I've been watching Holocaust movies? Well, that was done. That was dusted. I forgot about that. I hadn't really done anything. But after I'd mentioned this, he recommended a movie to me. I never put two and two together, so I thought he was just recommending a fun movie to me. It's called Life is Beautiful. It's an Italian film called La Vita Belle or something, right? Like in the original language. So I watched that, and I didn't watch like a dub or anything. I watched the original with English subtitles. Really old movie. I don't even know the year that it came out, to be honest, but it was a very old movie. And I didn't know what to expect. So I was like, yeah, this is pretty cool. Two kind of old guys, lots of very slapsticky, kind of happy, jovial comedy. Like, it just seemed like an old kind of comedy, just a bit of a fun romp. And the movie opens with this really happy soundtrack, like la-di-da-di-da. And it even starts by saying, this is just a happy story, just a fun little tale. Nothing special about it, right? A story of love or something. So you're expecting it to be one of these kind of cool, just turn your brain off and you enjoy it, right? Just be happy for a little while. And the guy who recommended it to me actually said the words that it was inspiring to him. So I was watching it. I was pretty interested. I was like, do you know, I'm sort of at a point where I like the dark and gritty movies, but do you know how you feel sometimes where you want to watch a movie, but like, it just feels like too much. You're like, oh, do I really want to get involved in this? Like, Jesus. But then you realize it's like a happy movie. It's like Toy Story. It's like a Pixar film. It's like a Disney flick. And you're like, oh, yeah, this is really good. This is just a happy-go-lucky. Like, I was really digging the movie, okay? Watching it about for about 40 minutes, this guy, about this life, his life in the city, is originally from the village. He keeps finding this girl and he's trying to woo her, and eventually he steals her away from the arms of this marriage she was almost going to fall into, and they fall happily in love, right? And then the movie really shocked me. As it was going through all this kind of happy-go-lucky stuff, every now and then there'd be some comment like, oh, we hate the Jews. Oh, our race is the superior race. Oh, you know, this is perfection. So there was like these slight like racist undertones every now and then. And I thought, okay, this is obviously like a happy movie on the surface, but it's showing like some of the really sick things that were going on in the time or whatever. But I thought it was just going to stay very minor. All of a sudden, about 40 minutes in, you realize that they're Jews. Oh, they're being carted off to the concentration camps. Oh, it's another Holocaust movie. Oh, everyone's dying. All these people that I'd grown to love. And it took a really, really sour twist. And all of a sudden, I was watching this depressing as hell movie, and I was not like...
Oh, no.
I didn't think I was in the mood for it. But those it was really turns. Interesting.
What a twist!
It's a classic movie. I think it's really one of the earliest movies to tackle the Holocaust kind of like a subject material.
Yeah.
The woman that he marries isn't even a Jew. And she just says, I want to get on the train. I don't want to live if you're going to take my husband and my son away. And he ends up with this son who, for the first like huge part of the movie, isn't even a character, but then becomes this really significant character. He's in the camp with his son and trying to convince his son that nothing bad is going on. And kind of the whole idea of the movie is, yeah, obviously the Holocaust is bad and stuff. But the main character is like... In my opinion, you know, I don't know whether you're really familiar with this kind of character type, but he's a relentless optimist to me, right? Like, this guy never gets sad that he's there. Most of the movie is just setting up the fact that every time life deals him a bad hand, he just kind of takes it on his stride and he goes off and he makes something good out of it. And he's really, really happy constantly. And literally, then you watch how he experiences life when he gets into a concentration camp, like the worst of the worst of the worst. How can this man stay optimistic? How can he stop his son from realizing that they're in such a terrible, horrific place? And I won't spoil the end or any of like the core stuff, but it was an interesting movie, if not, you know, really depressing. And I didn't want to watch another depressing movie, but
well,
yeah,
I watched two movies that were could be seen as depressing. I watched Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and I saw Dragon Ball Z Battle of the Gods.
Right? Okay.
That's supposed to be like, my friend was like, oh, the original guy made the Dragon Ball Z movie, dude. We gotta watch it, man, because he was coming. He got moved. He got relocated because he's a manager of the CarMaxes in some of the CarMaxes in South Carolina. So he came down there and said, what's up to me, of course, obviously. And it was his birthday on the 29th as well. So he came down, we watched Dragon Ball Z. And it's one of those movies where you can't watch it expecting...
Is it new, for what it's worth? Is it
it's
like
a new, yeah, it's a newer one. Okay. Yeah. I think it was the latest one to come out. I could be wrong, but it's a relatively new one. You can't expect greatness from this movie. Expect to laugh, because basically it's making fun of the characters and what it represents throughout the whole entire movie, pretty much. Like, there's a scene where Vegeta just dances to make a god happy. Like, it was something that Vegeta would not do, you know? And I guess a later movie Vegeta will do, because, you know, he's trying to save the world. You have to watch it to understand. But, like...
Yeah, I was never really into DBZ, so I really don't get... Like,
yeah, this movie wouldn't be great for you to see, and then... And, I mean, you wouldn't get it unless you've watched it and grew up with it, and then you look at it, you're like, what is going on? But most of the time, we're just laughing and making fun of it, and we ended up enjoying it because of it. Even though it had really good scenes, like, there was a scene... when Goku was fighting this other god dude, and it starts with a B and I can't remember his name, but the main enemy, and he was saying some really cool like dialogue, and I'm like, wow, I'm like, holy crap, this is gonna get good right now. But then it kind of ends in a weird note. But it was overall a funny movie. It was more of a comedy, I think. Okay. Because just watching these characters burn, your childhood burn, basically. Just like everything just burn in front of your eyes. A lot of people enjoyed it. Probably didn't grow up on Dragon Ball Z the way me and my friend did. But, you know, a lot of people enjoyed it. I enjoyed it for the most part. Another one is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Okay? This is the one by executive all right, now, producer
we've
Michael
got a history.
Bay.
We've got a history a of talking about this on the pod already, all right? And you said you just wanted to enjoy it. Remember?
Yes.
Okay.
I enjoyed it.
I don't think you believe that, do you? You didn't like it, did you, Matt? The all first right, thing you I said try, to me just trying... now was that these were depressing movies in some way. Are you depressed that it wasn't very good?
No, DBZ, I'm fine with the way DBZ was. I'm okay. not... There was some laugh out loud moments. He looked like he just took it and ran wild with it. But Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, I swear, guys, I'm not this negative for everything. I swear.
All right, okay. What was the other film we saw that was a remake? Tron. Was it Tron? It wasn't Tron. Oh, God. RoboCop. Okay, which was worse?
Oh. Well, RoboCop wasn't really... All right, people misunderstand. I was bashing RoboCop a little bit because it was kind of...
Bad?
It didn't have any soul, I feel like. I felt like it could have been more. Like, if it was just very... mediocre, like a mediocre movie. And the only right. reason why it was good was because it had really good actors, right? With Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, it had some good actors in it. The turtles were actually pretty funny for the most part. For the most part, they were pretty funny and enjoyable to be around. Like, there's an elevator scene when they're making a, you know, like a beat and stuff. That was pretty funny. The rat was ugly. Did anyone agree with that in the comments? The rat is like ugly. I mean, I guess I expected him to look awesome, you know, in like a very Japanese anime type
super
style.
Sage.
Yeah, like he just looks ugly, but it's fine. I enjoyed the movie, but everything would have been fine. I would have enjoyed the movie just fine if it wasn't for Megan Fox. She really, really annoyed me.
But isn't she super hot?
That doesn't matter to me, though.
Well, what do you mean that doesn't matter? That's
it really
doesn't.
She's
tired.
Not hot in the right way for me. To be hot for me is something that comes beyond just good looks. It has to be, I don't know, a smart.
Well, that's what
type
changes
of
being
hotness.
Hot into beautiful.
Like, oh, she knows what she's doing. You know what I'm saying? Anyways. I like a strong woman.
Was she at any point in a bikini or underwear or anything?
No, it's nothing like that. It's her acting. There were scenes where she was just doing this like bad acting, like lines, and her roommate who acts better than her says, "Are you crazy?" Like she talked like she was like insane. Like Megan Fox talked like she was insane, like literally
but
insane. So
that,
I guess
well,
she did
that
a good
the character?
Job. They made fun of her during the movie.
Doesn't that mean that was intentional?
Intentional? Yeah, I guess it was intentional. That was the only way that would be acceptable, but it still annoyed the heck out of me. Like, she was still really bad. Everything else was actually pretty decent. Everything else. Okay. So I actually did enjoy the movie, but, like, I think what bothered me the most is her acting with the turtles. It's almost like she wasn't even there.
Shouldn't it have been like the turtles weren't even there since they were CGI?
Yeah, but like the turtles would act like she was there. They would, you know, like talk about her and blah, blah, blah. Like, and I don't know, like she just didn't react to them.
Right.
Like,
okay.
It's like the director didn't tell her, look, this is what they're going to be saying. React. And she
doesn't. I guess it is probably one of the hardest things to do in modern cinema, right? Like,
no,
acts.
There's been plenty of movies where people have done
this. I get that it's not impossible.
The Life of Pi. The Life of Pi. The guy was on a boat, in front of a green screen. That's it the whole entire time. He's never moved from in front of a green screen the entire time. And that movie was good. Like... She doesn't know how to act.
You don't forgive her at all.
She's bad, dude.
Oh, poor Megan Fox, man.
She's so
bad.
We might
need another podcast listener over there.
Dude, like at the end, guys, okay, if you've seen the movie, everything was fine. Let me look up the guy that was with her. He was doing a decent job. Really.
You seem really wounded over this.
No, not really wounded. It's just that I know that she was going to be the reason why I disliked
it. Oh, that's not good. If you already knew.
Will earn it. He was Vemot. He actually did a better job. He did a better job of knowing where the turtles were, like, on the screen. Sometimes Megan Fox will be looking in the wrong direction. To be honest, I'm just saying. It should be talking to air. There, I think because it went through a lot of changes, maybe something changed. But at the end of the movie, you see Megan Fox like just staring blankly into the turtles, blankly, not knowing what to say, not reacting to what they're saying. Like it boggles the mind, dude. It seriously boggles the mind.
I don't know what you want from me. Do you want me to convince you that she's good?
I'm done ranting. I'm done ranting. Michelangelo was macking with Megan Fox.
Okay.
And she would never react to it throughout the whole entire movie. Never react to it. Never make jokes. You know, you would think that they could do so many jokes with that, right? With with a big green guy. Yeah, like, there's so many jokes you can do there. None. She had no imagination. Anyways, I'm done. I think it's good. A good movie. You guys should watch it if you're not too... Like, I put myself in a frame of mind where I was like, I'm just going to enjoy this movie. Megan Fox made it hard, but I still got through
it
the movie.
It sounds like she made it impossible.
And it was cool to see some, like, the snow scene where, like, the Ninja Turtles is doing all the... craziness, like, that's pretty fun, but it's not necessarily the, you know, like, oh, you should go out and watch it in theaters. No, it's not that type of movie. It's one of those movies where you sit down with your kids and watch a good eye candy movie.
All right, that doesn't sound bad. I do think movies like that have a place. It does suck that there's slight weak bits, but if overall it was okay.
Yeah. I think it was okay. I mean, you could pick this movie apart, but I don't want to do that anymore.
I don't think you did today. I think you were really level.
I only complained about Megan Fox. Everyone else was fine. I'm not gonna talk about Shredder. I'm talking about all the other villain. I forgot his name already.
Like what? What else was wrong in the movie, man?
Anyways, we've hit an hour, which means question time!
Dun, 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 dun.
Hi. I interrupt this broadcast because we forgot Movie Club. So I decide just to pick a random movie. The Goonies. All right, see you next week.
Mm, dun, 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 dun. Dennis Christensen says, oh, I don't actually have a riddle. We'll do that next podcast.
Then why did you put it there? Or did I put it there? I put it there because someone mentioned it in the comments.
I put it there.
Great.
And then I forgot.
that's fine. I'll get a riddle once you pull up the questions.
Okay, I've already got them up. So, I mean, that's some lightning fast Googling you got to do there.
Yeah.
All right. Dennis Christensen says, I guess you need some more questions for the next podcast. So here's one. What upcoming games are you looking forward to the most? Halo MCC. No question. We talked about it before, but that's all I care about. That is my life right now. It's going to be insane in the membrane. Insane in the game.
So other than Dragon Age Inquisition, because I'm going to be reviewing it, hopefully
oh, that's
get
true
a review
as well.
Copy.
If your review, this is one of the first times I know 100% based on your review will determine if I buy that game. Just throwing it out there. Can you have a section in the review that's basically, this game good if you never played the first two?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Let me write that down. Because
that's the position I'll be in, and I would love to have that perspective.
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Is this game good?
This is just like us working right now. This is not a podcast. This is just us like, oh, you should do this. Just take a second to type away. Yeah.
Of course, I'm looking forward to Halo just as much as he is. I grew up with Halo. It's one of those games where it's just like, it's a must. I have to buy an Xbox One to buy Halo. That's just it. I know you guys won't really understand it if you never grew up with Halo, but I grew up with LAN parties and straight up playing on Legendary, getting every skull for every single Halo game that ever existed. Except for 4. I didn't do that with 4 because did not care about 4.
Anymore, yeah. If they're at all interested in story and stuff, that trailer that they just released that shows all the remastered cutscenes of 2 and like cuts it together will prove why it is one of the greatest video game sci-fi franchises that exists. Honestly, and that's up against some tough competition. That's up against friggin' Mass Effect. Is StarCraft really that good for the story? I know it's a big franchise.
Yeah. I enjoyed the Kerrigan story. What was it? Swarm of the Heart? Heart of the Swarm?
Heart of the Swarm, yeah.
Swarm of the Heart. It sounds like a soap opera. A romance song. Sounds like a soap opera.
You are the swarm of my heart. But yeah, great game. That new trailer has me so pumped. Oh, the brutes look so good. The prophets look so good.
Oh my
with
god.
All the hair and stuff.
I'm a little disappointed with the they seem like in that preview I sent you, they said that Halo 3 wasn't really touched up much. And I'm really sad about that because that was one of my favorite Halos.
Well, because there's not really that much to touch up, in my opinion. Like, it already was pretty stunning. Yeah, I mean, it's getting the 1080p 60fps treatment like the others. True. It's just there's not that much to change, I guess, you know? Like, there's less reason to do the cutscenes and stuff. What I was really shocked about with, you know how they hired this company, Blur, to do all of their cutscenes?
Right.
There was this, in Halo 2, with one of the map packs that they released, they also did a special little bonus cutscene that's about 5 to 6 minutes long, showing the fate of some Marines who, like, split up from you at some point in the main story. And during the main story, you don't see what happens, but later you reunite and that's it. And years ago, they did a map pack where they released this bonus cutscene where you get to see what happened to those Marines. And surprisingly enough, in the Halo 2 anniversary, they didn't just redo all the main cutscenes of the game. They even went back and did this random cutscene that they did from a map pack as well. Like, they did everything. There's so much they did. Like, the attention to detail is insane. It's like all these little shocking things. It's like, oh, yeah, this is something even more quality, even more bang for your buck. Everywhere you look, it's the value is unreal. It's crazy.
Real quickly, top of my head, there's gonna be some games that Hyper Light Drifter has to be one of the games I need to play. That I need that in my life. Bloodborne, I need to play that. I'm more of a Demon Souls fan. I haven't really finished the part one. I know I haven't played part one, and I need to finish part two because I've been saving it because I want to live stream the rest of it since I didn't get to finish the Let's Play. But there's another game that's coming out near the end of the... Oh, well, Assassin's Creed Unity looks pretty good. I always play the Assassin's Creed games. I don't know why. It's because I really enjoyed 1 and, you know, 1 and 2 when Desmond and stuff. You know, a lot of people didn't enjoy Desmond, but I enjoyed Desmond quite a lot, actually. I enjoyed those parts, and I thought that...
I'm glad they got rid of him. They made the story so much better.
Yeah. Man, I don't like that. I mean, if you agree with that, then that's fine, but... I was thinking that they would have, instead of making it into a franchise and diluting the whole series, which, you know, I can't complain because they make some really good games. You know, the Unity thing is going to be like multiplayer and stuff, and I think that's going to be cool. But
yeah, but that could have been a different story, dude.
Yeah, I know.
There is no excuse
exactly.
for it. It sucks.
Exactly.
It shouldn't have become a franchise. It should have been three, maybe four really linear, well-done games that tell an overarching story that, yeah, had a proper arc for Desmond and stuff. Then it would have been amazing. It would have gone down in history.
Can you imagine what they would have to do to make, you know, like... New York or whatever city he was in, you know, being able to like assassinate
and
people.
And that's the ultimate game.
Yeah, it would be amazing. It would be amazing. Maybe the technology's not there yet for the type of ideas they would like to do. But like,
maybe
still.
It's not technology, but maybe it's because it's such an intimidating space going up against any free roaming city kind of game now is automatically pitted against GTA. And Rockstar is so insanely good at what they do. It's like any other game that goes in that space, Watch Dogs is a great example, kind of crumbles. And so Assassin's Creed, plus such a defining part of Assassin's Creed as a franchise, is obviously the old aesthetic and the old cities and stuff. So it would have been a huge gamble to make a game like that, and I can understand why they didn't. But I still think it deserved its own plot.
Sunset did pretty good. They had really good level design, I think. Because you have to keep grinding in and bouncing off stuff. Man, there were no times where I was like, okay, I had nothing to get up onto the railings or anything like that. There was always
it looked really good after you got like that double jump thing or the fly thing.
Yeah, there was a lot of good moments. Just like trying to, I can't fit everything I would like without spoiling so much of the game.
Yeah,
so I have to like hold back on a lot of stuff that I've captured because I captured the entire game. So, you know, and hopefully if the Elgato works, we'll have a better solution for that.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Yeah. You gonna do a review on your channel, Facecam?
Maybe. Mm-hmm. The next question is from Marius, who says, when has there been a proper fat or overweight game protagonist or main character recently? Chubby like Wario or... Oh, damn it, I was going to say Wario is my answer here. Or big like a Norn don't count. Wario's pretty fat. Come on. Oh, that's not chubby, that's fat. Because otherwise, I think I've just discovered discrimination against fat people in games. Yeah, I don't know. It is pretty bad, right? There's not that many.
I think it has a lot to do with... it's the same reason why they put women in distress in games. It's because people want to feel like they're the big, tough guy. They don't want to feel like they're big. Because society really, you know... I guess kind of like... Everyone is skinny. Everyone's models... You see, like, all these models in the industry, they're always, like, really thin, you know, or the guys are always ripped and stuff like that, and that's considered sexy.
You know,
that's considered handsome, when really, like, I don't know. I really disagree with that. I agree with being healthy and, you know, losing weight to a more... healthier weight so you won't die. There's been many people in my life, well, not many, but there's people in my life, especially my wife's mom, who has died because they were overweight.
Right.
Like it got to the point that it was just too much. That stuff is dangerous. Like putting on too much weight is very dangerous. So I don't know. People don't, yes, society kind of just like puts people like, you know, like that, like no one wants to be fat, blah, 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 blah.
Like, there's this whole argument, okay, that a lot of people put forward that I actually think is overrated. And that's the idea that we want video game characters that we can relate to, that we want to put ourselves on as them, right? So the more like us that they are, the more realistic they are. And a lot of people swear by that and they say, oh, this is what we definitely want from games. That's what the average person wants. But I don't agree with that. I really don't believe with that. It often comes up with arguments about women only ever having skimpy outfits and stuff in MMOs or whatever, right? But if it often turns out that even girls playing games, they're happy to play, you know, the pretty girl wearing the skimpy clothes with the perfect figure and stuff.
Yeah.
Just as much as guys like to play guys that are super ripped, right? Like, yeah, it's kind of an interesting idea. Yeah, fat gamers want a fat protagonist to play as, but in general, I think mostly people want to play, you know, what they'd love to look like or whatever. And I do think that's true, that we would rather just be the idealized type of people.
Yeah, Saints Row has that, where you can just play whatever you want. Big guy, small guy, whatever. And I think that's great. It's because you want to play that way. But as a main protagonist, that's the only way to play the game. I think it would have to be with mechanics and stuff. Like, there has to be a reason why he's overweight. You know, like he has some type of superpower that makes him be able to bounce a roll.
You're constantly eating. Pac-Man. Is Pac-Man fat?
Yeah.
Constantly eating. That would make sense. I'll tell you what, though. We both played a game with a fat guy who was the main character.
What was that?
The Raven, baby. He was pretty overweight.
Oh,
he was pretty old as well.
Right.
He wasn't ideal.
Yeah. See?
But that wasn't a very popular game.
It was not.
You know, and we
it
appreciated
was not.
It.
I was about to say that.
You could make what's his face in San Andreas really fat as well. I googled this and that was one of the first answers that came up. CeeLo or whatever his name was. It wasn't CeeLo, was it? But you could make him really fat.
So there you go. We gave you like a list of games where you can play as bigger characters. Yeah, because I made, it's funny because I made that joke in Overdrive where it's like, it, like, I don't need to relate to my character. I don't look this ripped in real life. There's no way in hell. You know, like, I don't need to.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, hey, it's the skimpy girl outfits, though. I'm not going to lie. Like, what about you? Do you like playing women in video games? Not necessarily for the skimpy outfits, but do you like playing women in video games? Because I tend to, depending on what video game it is, I tend to like playing the girls. And people always tell me, like, why are you playing a girl? I'm like, why? What's wrong with a girl? Like, I don't understand. Why is it such an issue? It's the same thing.
Yeah,
like,
I guess I don't really know where I stand on it, because my default thought would be, oh, I just play the guys. But if I look at my GW2 account, most of my characters are females. And one of the only males I have on my account is a big blonde Norn that's supposed to look like it's dressed up as a girl, right? Like, so I don't know. I guess I pick girls a little bit more now just because it's a little bit more interesting to me.
Yeah.
I'm just like, and I do, there is definitely, with my Mesmer, I had a human Mesmer who was a male for ages. And when I turned him into a girl with a makeover kit, I was like, oh yeah, just the armors and stuff looked way better.
Way
better.
I could play Barbie. Oh my God, it looks so weird. Not to hate on the male Mesmers out there, but it looks so much better.
Yeah, right? Like, and I was like, oh, you get all these cool different fabrics and stockings and shoes. Man, you really get to embrace a certain side of yourself that most men don't get to.
Exactly. In Sunset, I was like, man, I'm like, the girls, I really actually really liked the male, how the male looked. It was really cool to design them. I was like, man, this is really awesome. It's been a while since I felt that way. And, and the women, of course, equally as awesome. Women in video games are always awesome. They're always awesome.
A weird thing, though. You know, I'm playing Grimrock at the moment, Grimrock 2. I've only just realized this about myself. I didn't consider for a second, not a split second, never even entered my mind, having a single one of my four characters be a female. They were just all males in my mind. Never even considered it was an option to make them female. I was like, male, 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 male.
Oh yeah, you and didn't if I know ever that the options at the bottom.
No, female? I knew the option was there. I looked at the portraits. I saw there were female portraits. I never considered for a second that I'd ever want to click one of them. And now that I look back, I'd probably think, actually, yeah, I could have had a female. That would have been kind of cool if my Rattling was female. But it's too late, and like that never even crossed my mind. It's the same with like if I play like single player RPGs. Like you were talking in your review about how sometimes the female voice actor is better, for the voice artist is better. And so lots of people played FemShep. I never would have considered in a million years when I was playing Mass Effect
never.
Using FemShep.
I didn't consider until after I finished the series and everything. And people was like, oh yeah, Jennifer Hale, like she's very good and she's better than the male Shepard because he's very like stale and stuff. And I didn't think so. And now that I'm realizing, it's like, yeah, there's some lines there that were a little bit dry, but he was just a different person. And that's what it is. Like it's a different person entirely. Like in Sunset Overdrive, the girl was like a very geeky sounding woman. And the jokes came off differently because of that. Because her personality was just different.
Yeah, your review never really made it clear. Is it still all the exact same dialogue? The delivery is just different.
Yeah.
Interesting.
But it's in a different voice, and it made it different. I don't know if I would have enjoyed it. I think I'm glad I played with a male because there were some really good scenes when the male voice actor really shined. And I felt like I don't know, I played a lot of the few missions, and the cutscenes were a little bit like the woman. It's the voice actor. I'm not talking about just as a female, just the voice actor. Because man, if someone else like Jennifer Hale, who's done a lot of voiceover work, and I looked up the person who did Sunset Overdrive, she didn't do much work before this. You know, she did some stuff, but not much.
Okay.
You know, so I can see that she's coming in. I think people are going to like her. Some people are going to like that geeky type of sound. But with the way the story was going, it just didn't fit her voice. It just didn't fit. And I probably would have not liked it as much. But Anything else? We can move on to the riddle. Riddle, riddle, riddle.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So this is the first time you're giving me a riddle.
Yeah. I have to press to get the solution. So okay. I'm not going to know the solution, unlike you.
All right. Okay. Let's do it. We'll work it out together, yeah?
Okay. Let's do that. Hopefully these are not, like, easy. This seems like an easy one.
An easy one's good. We're running over anyway.
All right. What can you catch but not throw?
A cold.
Let me see. Yeah, that was too easy.
Well, boom! No. That's good. That makes us look smart.
No. What's black and white and red all over?
A newspaper.
Oh, I guess I do have to know the solution, don't I?
Yeah. What was it? Is it a newspaper?
Nope. Oh, what? No, it is.
Yeah, boom, oh, there we go. That's two in a row, baby.
There's four solutions here. An embarrassing skunk.
An embarrassed skunk, wow.
A zebra painted red.
Okay.
A sunburnt penguin and a newspaper. Okay.
All right, the newspaper's the sophisticated answer. I've heard the sunburnt penguin as well.
Well, there
before.
You go. There you go. So, obviously you would have to pause and guess it. And then figure it out, you know, and then, I mean, play the podcast. So hopefully you guys know how to do that because we solved it pretty fast. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the podcast. We will see you next week. Leave us a review.
iTunes review.
An iTunes review. And then like us on stuff that
can
be liked.
I like how you almost went into your old outro there. Did you hear that?
What?
For a little while, you almost went into, like, your old outro.
Yeah, I tend to do that sometimes.
That's so ingrained in you now.
Yeah. I used to have a big problem with stay visual, and before that,
problem.
Give me a like, share with your friends, leave a comment, and say what's up in the comment section below, and stay visual.
You're going to get people saying, oh, I really miss that now. You know that.
Really?
The thing is, last thing you mentioned as well in the podcast is the last thing they hear before they leave a comment, and that's all they're going to be like. They're going to be like, "Oh, I missed that."
But it's a long, like, some people take it differently. Some people like, "Oh, I like him having something the same every time you end the video," and then some people are like, "Oh, it's very childish and oh, you know, it's like a barrier. Oh, you shouldn't ask for likes and comments and stuff."
You just
got to
find what you personally.
Yeah, like, I don't care if someone asks for a like. If I'm watching a YouTube video, which I watch a lot of YouTubers, I don't care if they ask for a like. You know, some of the biggest guys ask for that. Like, who cares? Yeah. Who cares? Like, I don't care, but
the only thing with me is when someone asks for a like, it's pretty much the instant I click off the video, because I just assume that after that, the next 10 seconds or whatever, nothing important is going to get said at all.
Oh, no, not in the beginning of the video. I'm talking about at the end.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm talking about as well. So if they end the video by saying, give me a like and then loads of other stuff, I just assume that at that point it's nothing I really care about and I just instantly click off.
Damn.
So, yeah. Because it's just going to be like the whole line.
So
right?
That's what you did for my videos when I used to do that.
Yeah, no, I would. Yeah, I'd hear you start saying it and I'd just turn off straight away because there's nothing else that I want
to
watch.
That's something to know. That's actually interesting. I never thought about it like that.
Yeah.
Consumer. Like, I tend to listen to a lot of the stuff. I mean, it depends.
What's the point in listening, though, if you know what it's going to be?
True. Very true. Very true.
You know, that was my little thing anyway.
Anyways, guys, give me a like, share with your friends, leave a comment, say what's up in the comment section below, and stay visual!
Red, look out, our pants!